Meantime, some unfavorable numbers released today for Justin Trudeau, just about 6 months or so before we all head to the polls in that federal election. This poll is by the folks at Léger. They show that Justin Trudeau, his government, his party, sank to a new low this month. Look at this, 27% of people, only 27, saying they would vote for the Liberals. That is 13 points behind the Conservatives, led by Andrew Scheer, at 40%. That is, by the way, within range of a majority. The NDP, way back at 12%. Interestingly, the Green Party, not far behind them, with 11%. And as for the People's Party, by Maxime Bernier, they're only at 3%. So what do these numbers actually mean? And let's be clear, we're still a long way away from an actual election, but it will be called, in all likelihood, in September. Pauline Benj is standing by, political science professor at the University of Toronto. And I say September because we remember last time around, Pauline, Stephen Harper called it really early, in, you know, early August, and that campaign went on for 10 weeks. We'll see whether Trudeau goes early or late. But what about the poll? How worried should the Liberals be with those numbers?
I think they should be very concerned because there have been a number of problems, as you and viewers know, SNC-Lavalin, plus really alienation of the voters in many provinces across Canada with delays on the Trans Mountain Pipeline and so on. So he is going to have to work very hard.
Do you think some Canadians are getting sort of turned off by Justin Trudeau, by his leadership, by the decisions that he made, by his handling of different things, including the SNC-Lavalin scandal? I mean, you know, the bloom is off the rose for sure, but what do you make of these numbers?
Well, it appears that Andrew Scheer is rising in popularity. He is someone who is carrying himself well. He has made no major gaffes, whereas Mr. Trudeau's constant or near constant parrying of questions without direct answers, people get tired of that pretty quickly.
If the SNC-Lavalin scandal was something of a political near-death experience for the Prime Minister, we know that it has faded from the headlines, though, Pauline. We don't know what's yet to come. But, you know, 4 months is a long time for people to forget some of the details, to move on. You know, you get out there in the barbecue circuit in the summertime. And you know, that's a long time for Justin Trudeau to turn those numbers around.
Yes, that's you are exactly right. Voters take into account a number of long-term factors. Have they liked the Liberal Party for three decades? Well, they're unlikely to switch, even if they don't like the current leader. So there's very long-term considerations, but also the economy is close to mind for pretty much every Canadian, whether they're retired, working, coming out of university, and we just don't know what the economy is going to bring in the next 4 months.
So, yeah. The other thing I'm curious about is, you know, when you look at provincial elections in the last couple of years, there does seem to be an appetite for change, possibly to the right. We saw that most recently in Prince Edward Island and in Alberta, of course. So this anger with the establishment, the status quo, I mean, the Prime Minister is now part of that because he won and is the Prime Minister. Does that put him at risk as well, that he is now seen as being part of the system?
I will do a classic yes and no. There's two ways you can look at it. On one hand, yes, what you've just said, Canadian voters seem to like more conservative policies, not in the sense of conservative not changing, but just a different approach. On the other hand, there is also the fact that Canadian voters are shrewd and they may be voting for conservatives at the provincial level in order to hold the Liberal Party accountable at the federal level. So there's two ways to interpret the data.
Pauline, wonderful to have you with us on this Sunday. Thanks for taking a bit of time for CTV News, as always.